Alright, good morning everybody. Richie Plemons of Plemons Lawn and Landscape. So, we're getting ready to head out this morning, but you know it's officially spring when you come out and your vehicle is yellow. So, you know, you wonder when spring's going to be here? Well, start seeing yellow on everything. I can see it or not. Can I see the all the yellow pollen? You know it's springtime when your vehicle's yellow around. So, but anyway, we've got we got about 10 yards to knock out today, so we're gonna get at it and bring you guys along with us as usual and see what we can get into. And better turn that down. We don't want YouTube give me a copyright strike for the radio playing in the background. So, but anyway, so today is Thursday, March 29th. It's my birthday, and I'm another day older, and I probably shouldn't tell everybody that. Tell everybody it's my birthday, but anyway, what do you guys do on your birthday? I work. It's just another day to me. So, but let's go get these yards done and get those looking good. We got some rain coming in this afternoon, and we want to get it taken care of before it gets here. So, anyway, guys, let's get at it. Portion's done. Now we got to do the weed eating and the edging, get everything blowed off, and we'll have yard number one complete. So this is our first yard of the day, and we've got about 10 to do today. So let's get the weed eating and everything done and get out of here. All right, that completes yard number one. So take a look at it. Kind of I've showed this lawn a couple of times. I mean, it's like I said, it's one of my favorite lawns. It's a beautiful fescue. I've got two that are just great fescue lawns to be cutting, and most of you know down here in the south we don't get a whole lot of fescue, so when we do, we really like to baby those and show those off. So, but anyway, we're going to our next one. It's kind of a weedy yard. I may get a little bit of footage with the GoPro, probably won't get any on the Canon, so get a little on the GoPro, maybe some action shots there. Probably won't do a whole lot of talking, so we'll get it taken care of. And then from there, we're going to a yard that's going to be the first cut of the season. It's a weedy yard, and it's a bi-weekly yard, and it's, like I said, it's going to be their first cut of the season. So it'll be my first time seeing it right along with you guys. So I've not seen it yet, and nobody else has seen it yet. So we'll kind of see that one together and see what that lawn looks like. So kind of worried about it, but they just called and said, hey, let's get started. So we don't start their lawn until they call us every year. Here it is the last week of March. He's just calling me. So I'm kind of worried about how thick that's gonna be, but we'll see when we get there. All right, guys, here we go. All right, here we go. First mow of the season on this property. So you can take a look at it. It's pretty tall. I made one little pass here at the front, getting off the trailer there, but as you can see, it's a pretty tall property, or a pretty tall grass on this property to start the year. So let's get set up and get it mowed and get it looking good again and ready for the summer. But the old trusty Ferris Z2 cut right through it. I mean, we cut that down to being a, every 2 week yard they want to cut pretty low, so we cut that all the way down to 3 inches just to kind of make it manageable every couple weeks when we come by. So, but yeah, that was pretty thick for the first cut of the year. And like I said, though, the Ferris tore right through it. Anyway, guys, I'm going to finish this up, get it blowed off, go get the next one. It's starting to cloud up, rain's coming, so we gotta move quick. So see you guys shortly. All right, everybody, so that gets the last one. We're finished. You know, it's rain starting to come in, and so we got that last one knocked out for the day, and we're gonna go to the house. I'm gonna enjoy some birthday cake and see what the wife's making me for dinner. I tried to talk her into fish. I'm a huge fish eater. I love fish, so I'm trying to talk her into some salmon for the night, so maybe some mahi. I know we got both of them in the freezer. Maybe I get one of them. But anyway, guys, we're finished for the day. Not like I said, you know, these daily vlogs, I'm not gonna do a whole lot of video on it every yard. I mean, I give you kind of an idea of what we do for the day, and that's about it. Nothing major, nothing big. Got some videos coming up. I'm gonna do some reviews on all my green touch racks coming up pretty soon. I've had them now on here for a couple of months, and let you guys know what I think of them and how they're working. And then we've got the Red Armor Challenge coming up. If you guys don't know what the Red Armor Challenge is, check out echomeansbusiness.com. Echo puts on this Red Armor Challenge. Basically what we're doing is we're going to take a small camera, we're going to run it down inside one of our pieces of equipment that's never run any of the Echo oil in it, and take a look at the top of the piston inside and everything, the engine, and see what kind of buildup we've got. And then we're going to run Red Armor all summer long and see if it cleans that engine up. So it says that it will clean the engine while lubricating everything, so we're going to try it out, see if it cleans up the engine, how clean it gets, and I've got a six pack that I'm going to send out and give to some guys to try out. I'm sending mine out to Nickens Lawn and Landscape. We're going to send it out to those guys and let them try it out and see if they like it, and maybe we can turn on another customer there for Echo to pick up some of the Red Armor. Of course, most of you know I run majority Stihl equipment. I don't run all Echo. I do run mostly Stihl equipment, and I'm going to run that in my Stihl FS90 this year and try it out and see what I think about how clean the engine is. So but anyway, guys, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit that bell button. That way you get notifications every time we get a new video posted up. So but anyway, guys, I'm out of here. You guys have a good one. We'll see you tomorrow.